And now, D. Pollen. Senya Pale, Mwere Pupale, Tongu Yoe, Kowa Lume, Kite Cheche, Mejo, Pisi Tuki, Pedi Kisa. This language I learned first, the cadence, the dance that sways with my tongue. Le moi parle Kreyol. When I speak Kreyol, I have the voice of Haiti in my throat, thirsting to tell stories that may never be translatable, but will always end with hope, and for that, they will always be worth telling. Tessolet, Haiti. Poverty bleeds internally there. She lives in the city of the sun, 5 children, husband dead, murdered for supporting TT. They beat her, they stalk her, they beat at her, how she beat them by hiding. She lives in the city of the sun where she married again, married a man who raped her daughter, ripped her heart more, 6 children, new baby, no money. She lives in the city of the sun where water floods her home, wade in the water, her family waits in the water, in the city of the sun where it seldom shines, so turn the sun on its pregnant belly over the horizon, birthing femme haïtienne, Haitian women, mountain women, militant mountains, Demon, behind the mountains are more mountains, Demon, like a million hills rolling before the sun. These women carry resistance in their sweats. They walk in worn shoes, calloused feet. Dark skin glistens in the noon sun. Veins map their hands. River water pumps through Haiti's dried land as their stomachs empty. Sagging breasts like eroded hillsides. The women carry water on their heads, water in their wounds, water off their floors. They are potomitan, center pillars holding a collapsed house while the sun breaks dawn like coconuts cracked open with machetes. These women bat and beat back the dark, turn the sun on its pregnant belly over the horizon, birthing a new day. Laugh the women, we are still here. And we run the book, neighborhood watchers. Beat water our poles on rocks. Write secret messages in the money. Be at water when the sun goes into labor and you will see her. Negotiate peace with Columbus. These women rest in her story, burning souls rest in her blazing sun. They cut the sun's head off in Cité Soleil, Haiti. These women birth a new one every day. Mountain women, militant mountains. Demon, Simon, behind the mountains are more mountains. Demon, Simon, like a million hills rolling before the sun. These women carry Haiti in their sweats. new book called Dreaming in Kreyol. They'll be in the back. Her smiling face shone in the Outubomi sun. Black skin, silky, blue, black, purple, coffee bean black, with pearls for teeth. I stood, perplexed by my 13-year-old mind. Blue, black, beautiful. The light grew over my head like the hazy sun. Knew when I came back, if they ever called me ugly, if anyone mistook my dark for dreadful, if they ever called me cockroach again, it was a bold lie. This skin and all the dark in it is mine and beautiful. We are beyond it. They say we run in hills barefoot with dust in our hair, but we are beyond it. They say we made a pact with the devil that we threw hexes with voodoo to overthrow colonial rules, but who knew? We have more people going to church in Toulon and Lugals, and so what? We still dance and sway our hips to music of mountains where our ancestors stood plotting when we were slaves, when we were rebels, when we were revolutionaries revolutionizing revolution until we were free. We revolted. We signed no papers. We took their papers. We made new papers. We negotiated with no one. 1804 spread war on our kidnappers and claimed our independence because we were people. We were people with dreams. We had lost our fathers. We had lost our mothers. We had lost our lands. We had lost ours. We were angry. We were hopeful. We were determined. We were black. We were black blue. We were the people needed. La Belle des Antilles. We were the richest colony in the world. Sugarcane, cotton, cocoa, tobacco, and indigo, Haiti, land of mountains in the Arab language. Despite poverty's winds, we stand like mountains. Despite terror's rain, we stand like mountains. Despite the drought of death, the flood of false promises only redefines our size. We don't move for the convenience of others. We are mountains. We stand like we stood aside Americans fighting in the American Revolution. While we were still slaves, we stand like Bookman, like Toussaint, like Christophe, like Jean-Jacques Dessalines, Emperor King. We stand like why we let black Americans emigrate to Haiti before ethnicity, before island rivalry, before when just being black is a thing to be because we were one. We are one. We are African, period. They say we're not American, but the American city, Chicago, was founded by a Haitian, Jean-Baptiste Kwanisabla. They say we live in hell. We live on earth, in Outubomi, Gonaï, Port-au-Prince, Port-au-Prince, Jacmel, Brooklyn, Boston, Miami, Spring Valley, Georgia, Montreal, Jamaica, France, and the world. They say you can't even pick up a prostitute down there without genuine fear of AIDS. Well, you can't pick up a prostitute anywhere without genuine fear of AIDS. They say our literacy rate is high. We are beyond it. We have become linguists who speak French, Creole, Spanish, and English. We have become presidents, prime ministers, doctors, lawyers, RNs, LPNs, musicians, poets. We have become. We were enslaved. We were taken. But we have become Haiti, the second oldest republic in the Western Hemisphere after the United States, the oldest black republic in the world. For our sons, for our daughters, for our freedom, we may die in beautiful. And it doesn't matter now what they say. They say we are the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere. I say we are beyond it. This month, on January 12th, marked the 6th year anniversary of the earthquake that shook Haiti's world.
Peter Vaughn!
like the dry months, no replies rain down except the tears from our eyes. Tonight, we see the stars, and they are our only company. And for those of us who cannot see from beneath debris, hear the men, women, children scream, get pity, have mercy, and we wait. We wait. We wait. We wait for our hungry stomachs to survive another day of waiting, for our tongues to taste more than our spit, for our lungs to breathe the air again, though such the decay of rotting bodies, our eyes long to see the living pulled out from the rubble and walking among us again. We don't sleep. We wait for the earth to shake again and again. And again, so many times we all rest outside under a star-studded sky. It has become our blanket. It has become our roof. It has become our truth, a newfound possibility as we walk the streets of Kapu and Lilgun and Port-au-Prince confused. The palace has become a center for aid. We get to see what real changes this earthquake has made. The Catedral Palais National are gone, but we remain strong. Our businesses, our hospitals, our schools, our homes have crumbled, but we still dig through the rubble. We still dig. We are still here, and we wait for God. We wait for the world. We are still here. We are still strong. At night, we fill the air with song. The earth cannot shake our hope. Our hope lives inside us, and we will survive this despite all questions. Why? Our answer.
Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand. At night we fill the air with song. Our hope remains unshaken. That's why we sing. Mirabana wa, mirabana kompan puki, mirabana wa, mirabana kompan puki. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand. At night we fill the air with song. That's why we sing. Peter Bona Way, Peter Bona Kwan Puki, Peter Bona Way, Peter Bona Kwan Puki. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand. Peter Bona, Peter Bona, Peter Bona Kwan Puki, Peter Bona, Peter Bona, Peter Bona Kwan Puki. Up ahead we'll see. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll understand why. Up ahead we'll understand why.